back. We sincerely apologize about that. We had a little
Sorry about that, folks. We had a little technical difficulty. Like, literally, we forgot to plug the computer in.
Yeah, our computer just kind of died.
Oops.
Kind of important.
Yeah.
Also, kind of an important part.
Also, Alyssa's running our producer. She's our producer here tonight. And she's running, all of a sudden, she goes, Goff? And I'm like, yes, because I'm watching the game here. She goes, I looked over and our computer's completely blank. Went, that's a bad thing.
Yeah, that's kind of a bad
thing.
Then
we looked down and went, oh, yeah, the computer's not plugged in and just completely drained. The stream's draining real fast. So we sincerely apologize for that. Actually, you didn't miss a whole lot of action. You know, it's here at 7-4. Bearcats a little lead. So both teams kind of been scrapping. Some turnovers going on both sides there.
Scuffle for the ball on the floor.
Yep. Kaylee Hatcher and then number 23, Melody Flores. So, again, we apologize for that. Usually it doesn't happen. You can try to trust the stream usually most times here, but that literally was straight-up operator error. Actually, I said that's advisor error.
Exactly.
Because I set things.
That's even rarer to happen.
I set things up here, and I just kind of forgot to plug the computer in.
Yeah, I make mistakes all the time.
And the battery kind of just drained down. Oops. Again, apologies. 7-4, 2 minutes left here in the first quarter of action. Welcome back here, Kearney High School action. Bearcat, Lady Bearcats versus Lady Buffaloes. Garner tipped away. Kirsten Garner, nice hands. Nice job by 12. Kitsley Franco, 5 foot sophomore, or senior. Showing a little bit of speed there because Garner definitely is a fast young lady.
She is. It amazes me every time. Yeah,
Franco gets the foul but sends Garner to the free throw line. Going to make her earn them the hard way. Coming into the game right now.
Maddie Provins coming in for Tatum.
Back in the game, number one, Maddie Provins going out. Tatum rusher. Kaylee Hatcher in the game. That's 45 there. In for Garden City, number five, Julie Cosinetti. And number 30, Simone Simmons. Buffalo's going a little bit of size here. Probably a little size advantage over the Bearcats right now. Garner drops them both. 9-4 lead for the Bearcats. Garner her first 2 points of the day, evening. Nice pass over to Cosinetti. Basket on the way. Garner rebound. Trying to push up real court real fast. Seeing Rusher on the break. Rusher pulls it back. After Garner, think about three. Hatcher for three off left wing. That's good. Kaylee Hatcher.
Hatcher had a lot of threes yesterday, too.
Hatcher had a couple threes yesterday. Kind of broke the game open.
And Maddie Provins gets the ball again and goes straight in for the layup.
Oh.
And misses.
Maddie Provins with a wide open layup and rolled out the rim.
You know what? It happens sometimes.
It does. It's not that big a deal. It's not big. And board. I like it there. Coach Fletcher was the first one. Maddie missed that. Her head dropped. Coach Fletcher was the first one on that court. Smiled away. Now, I will tell you this, Sydney will not be that easy to little sister.
No.
Oh, yeah.
Sydney will not be that little sister. All right. Thank you guys for tuning in here. Bearcat Sports Network. We're going to take a little break. We'll be right back here with the final 105 remaining in the first quarter. Bearcats lead 12-4 over the Virginia Buffaloes.
For more than 162 years, FNBO has been with you where you are. A bank committed to helping you earn more and save.
All right, we're back here. The final 105 remaining here in this quarter. Bearcats lead 12-4.
Maddie Provins taking the ball.
Nice inbound pass to Hatcher. And Kaylee puts in for her 5th point of the evening. Kaylee leads all scores. Bearcats still staying in that diamond press defense. They've caused some kind of confusion for the Buffalo so far. Bearcats have built out a lead here, 12-4. Provins kind of tipped the ball away, didn't get up to it. Oh, yeah, Aspen kind of slapped down on her. Saw that one, so did the referee. That's a no-no, Aspen can't do that. That's Aspen's first foul of the game. Third team foul for the Bearcats. Buffaloes have 4.
Sydney Provins back in for the Bearcats.
And for Novacek, I believe.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Simmons, nice drive. She got a little bit too underneath the basket there when she went upstairs, just slammed it right underneath the basket.
Yeah.
So nice move to drive there. Just got a little bit too far underneath there. Couldn't flip it off the glass.
Yeah, Gardner bringing the ball in, and she looks like she's trying to set something up.
Yeah. Buffalo still kind of in the 2-3 zone. Oh, we're looking to switch out to man-to-man now. Bearcats going to run out here last 15 seconds. Out to Gardner, over to Aspen Rusher. Thinking up. Give it outside to Province. No good. Bounce off the rim. 4 seconds. 3 seconds.
One.
Oh, no good. That was a nice shot there by number 23, Mackenzie Lucas, at the end of the quarter, but no good. Half a second too late. And the one. Bearcats lead the Buffaloes 14-4. We'll be right back here. Bearcats Sports Network brought to you by First National Bank of Omaha.
This is going to be a good game.
And we're back here, Bearcat Sports Network, brought to you by First National Bank of Omaha. We want to thank all of our Bearcat Vision sponsors tonight. Runza, CHI Health, Parker Hannifin, Heartland Oral, and Landmark into some more here. Bearcats have the ball to start two, up 10 on the visiting Buffaloes. Oh, Province went down.
Rusher goes up for the three, and it just, like, rims off the glass and back over to her sister, Tatum.
Yep, off front iron.
Province has it back to Rusher, over to her sister, Aspen, up to Kirsten Gardner. Gardner to Tatum. Province has the ball, drives it in.
Over to Rusher. Did a lot of skip passes. Aspen's going up looking for a foul, didn't get it. Nice job by the Buffaloes. Hands straight up in the air.
Gallegos has the ball right now for the Buffaloes, and she's going to drive in to be met by Kirsten. Number five, Julie Calazzoni, goes in for a really nice layup.
Yep.
Gardner has the ball, and she's going to bring it in. Passes up to Aspen. Drives, and then passes over to her sister, Tatum.
The Bearcats have kind of passed the ball. They've seen something pass the ball over top of that zone.
Mm-hmm.
So, looking inbound for Novacek, foul on Simmons. That's going to be two on Simone Simmons. Kind of reached in on that one there. Yep. My guess is Simone Simmons is going to take some seat time. That's not a good thing probably for the Buffaloes. That young lady's battled hard and strong underneath the basket so far, but definitely don't want to pick up that third foul. We may not see her again for that second half. Top there. I think it's Province battling the ball, coming out. Nice pass to Novacek. I don't think she meant to the girl in white, though.
I don't think so.
Probably not.
Probably not. But we'll take it. A little home cooking. We're good.
I'm not complaining.
She drives in, passes up to Gardner. Gardner back to Rusher. Rusher over into Province. Novacek, and then.
A little off there. The Bearcats,
they're
inbounds.
The
three-pointer, Aspen Rusher,
there we are.
See, the Bearcats are trying to throw in that soft spot in that zone right in the middle of the plant, trying to plant Novacek in that soft spot in the zone, and when they collapse, they'll kick out and hit the outside shot. That's how you beat a zone defense, but you have to hit the outside shots. So far, the Bearcats have been doing it. 13.
Gallegos.
Nice job, Gallegos. So 8-foot jumper. Didn't go, hit Arn, but she followed her shot. All the Bearcats kind of looking around. Gallegos kind of followed her shot. That's good basketball skills right there, ladies and gentlemen. Young kids, watch what 13 did right there. That's how you follow a shot and got an easy putback for two. Novacek drove in, kicked out for three. No good.
Aspen Rusher kind of, like, got that rebound, but then she just, like, passed it.
Yeah, kind of flicked it, didn't she?
Yeah.
A little flick pass.
Yeah.
Trying to find the inside shot there. Aspen, no good. 23, I think, is Flores. Kind of disrupted Aspen's game there a little bit.
Yeah.
Couldn't quite get a smooth going, so.
But also, I'm pretty sure we've never versed this team.
Nope. Well,
and so.
Usually when a team's 4.5 hours away, we don't play them a whole lot.
You don't normally play them a whole lot.
I've been at Kearney High 16 years, and I don't remember ever playing them. So, but you know, that's it. It's kind of cool to play somebody different. And I hope we have reciprocity. I'm sure we will. I'm sure we're going to head to Garden City next year and play them. You know, I think Garden City got off to a late start. I think Kansas just started playing in January. I believe Garden City's first game was last night.
Wow.
I believe their first game was last night.
Props to them.
Yes. Bearcats
and
coming in.
It's not easy, folks. It's not. I've taken this from a competitive theatrics kid. I go on buses all the time. It's not easy being on a bus for 2 to 3 hours.
And they're 4.5.
And then they're 4.5.
Well, on a bus for 4 and 50. Oh, Garner, a little long. Falling shot. Hatcher, right to Hatcher. Nice swat. Good block there. I believe that was number 5, Calzonetti. Calzonetti?
I think it's Calzonetti.
We're going to go with that one. 21 on the way. 3-pointer, no good. Bearcat basketball, 17-8, 4:18 remaining.
As Gardner brings the ball in. Looks like the over to Rusher, to Hatcher.
Yeah, I'm not sure. What I looked at last night, I believe Garden City, their first game was last night. I think that was a whole Kansas. I think Kansas just delayed their start of their basketball season.
Yeah.
Rusher 3, no good. Which, if that was the case, that's going to be on Sydney Providence to reach in. If that's the case, huge advantage for the Bearcats. Bearcats have 8 games underneath their belt and probably a whole lot more practices. You know, when we talk about a 4-hour, 15-minute drive, come on, you're
a
high school kid.
Time.
You're a high school kid. You guys are up. Now, old people like me, I don't know about that one. I might need some Advil for my back.
We always need Advil for our butts after that.
All right, see a shot there. Coach Fletcher coaching his team up. Garner going to take a seat here. Good inbounds for the ball is number 5, Calzonetti.
Number 13, Gallegos for the Buffaloes. She's going to drive in, and Gallegos right now has been having a really, really good game.
Yep. Nice drive, basket off her. Soft off the glass. That was 30-30, Kiana Turner. Soft shot off the glass. Tough defense of the Bearcats. Good shot by Turner. Three-pointer open.
For the three.
And it's
good.
Number 33, Sydney Providence with 3, top of the key. That's the zone. Three-pointers will be open if you can hit them. So far, the Bearcats, I don't have my stat sheet. I'm sorry. I apologize. I don't have a stat sheet here. But I'd say Bearcats are probably about 30-35%, which is about season average. Nice put back there. I think that was 30. That's 23. Melody Flores. Final 2:42 remaining in this quarter here. Buffaloes have came in the quarter, 10-point deficit, cut it down to 8. So it's been about a stalemate this quarter. Bearcats have had some open shots underneath the basket. Just can't quite make them work. Oh. Yeah, dragged that foot there. She's trying to hold. She's trying to tiptoe, do those dance moves. Just good, quiet, do it down.
Refs don't like that.
No.
That's a no-no.
When you travel, don't like that.
Yeah, especially in basketball.
I mean, I think you can travel in soccer, but, I don't think that's an actual thing.
No. That gets why you blew the whistle.
Just a little bit.
Just a little bit.
Probably.
Way to go, ladies. Way to learn the rules of basketball.
Yes.
It's only taking you a few
don't
years.
Don't worry, folks. I actually do know most of the rules to basketball. Yeah. But
there we go.
Me, not so much.
Tatum drives in the ball, passes out to her sister, Aspen. And she's going to pitch it all the way over to Maddie Province. And look for something. Maddie back to Novacek. Novacek out to, looks like she's trying to pass out to Hatcher.
Hatcher thought about 3, no good.
To Rusher, to Province. and suspense. Buffalo stole the ball, and number...
Bearcats was trying to pass it around there, just couldn't quite make it work. Garner had a seat. She's up on the scorer's bench right now, point guard. Oh, Aspen saw that one just a tad too late. Got her fingertips on it, tipped it out. So, well, Garner was at the scorer's table to come in, and then she went back to take a seat. So, Coach Fletcher's going to let this one roll. Mm-hmm. Buffalo's outscored the Bearcats here, 8-6 in this quarter. Bearcats still lead by 8, 20-12. Team fouls are even, 5-5. Both teams all have. Bearcats have 5 timeouts left. Buffalo's have 4. Yep.
Double dribble.
Aspen trying to pull up there. Just kind of put both. Just kind of stopped, hesitated, then dribbled again there. Double dribble there. Good call by the trailing referee. Seeing
now, my favorite part of that was when the Buffalo team just erupted with
Oh, yes.
applause.
Yeah, they saw it right away. In the game, number 4, Kristen Roth, 5'9", junior.
First time she's going in.
Yes. Bearcats still playing diamond press defense here. Final 1:15 remaining in this second, in this first half. 5 3-pointer on the way, no good. Rebound by Novacek. Novacek, a UNK volleyball commit.
Let's go.
Oh. No good. Foul's gonna be on 33, Kiana Turner. Nice inlet pass there to Novacek. Could make work. Saw that. Also saw Novacek. She had a wide open layup off the glass and threw a little bit too hard. And she went, again.
Oops.
That's.
And then she just went to the other side and got a rebound.
Not sure poker. bounce. Hang on the rim a little bit. Dropped.
I'm thinking about it. Okay.
Yeah,
I guess.
We'll give you one.
That's me trying to get up in the mornings.
Yes. That's a mood.
Novacek makes first of 2. Open for 2 on the foot was on line, no good. Bounce side, nice rebound by Calzanetti. In pass. Kiana Turner for 2.
Prava's gonna bring the ball up and looks like she's gonna drive it in for a lane.
Yep.
Foul?
She just ran into somebody.
Saw a lane there, tried to drive in there, 21. Mackenzie Jagels a little bit too late getting over help defense. And that's blocking foul. No, that's what I like. They're trying to play aggressive. She went there for the charge, and she tried to get there. She was just a tad too late. She was still kind of moving, wasn't quite in the lane to stop, and that's impeding the traffic there. That's in. Guard City coming back in the game. It's 13 Gallegos. Bearcats up by 8. Second one, no good. Final 30 seconds. Oh, Bearcats lit defense. Got lucky there.
And it gets lucky there.
Yeah, Kristen Roth kind of snuck out the backside there. Bearcats didn't check her up at all the way, and she was all alone. She would have crowded that one. It would have been an easy layup. Nice cut in. No good.
Push.
Nice shot by 33 there. Kiana Turner got the ball. Looked over shoulder. And here comes in cuts Gallegos.
Foul was on Tatum Rusher.
Yeah, foul's on Rusher. That was her first. Mm-hmm. 6th foul for the Bearcats. Buffaloes have 7. 10 seconds remaining. First shot hit the back of the rim. Kind of almost stopped. No good. Good right now. Buffaloes outscore the Bearcats 10-8 this second quarter. Second one up. And also no good. See if Bearcats can do this final 10 seconds of the half. Inbound. Kind of hit Buffalo forehead. And now we go to halftime. Vic Kearney High School with the Bearcats. Our lead the visiting Buffalo is 22-14. We're going to take a break here. We'll be right back here at Bearcat Sports Network by second half action.
Are we going to stream?
Welcome back to the second half action.
Welcome back to your second half action here, just underway. For Garden City Kearney Bearcats. Bearcats lead 22-14. Quick drive for the Buffaloes, drop a first foul. Providence, Sydney Providence on her first foul of the game. Buffalo side maybe at halftime. Coach Pfeiffer. Then, hey, ladies, let's go to attack. Let's put it at them. Back in the game. I know the Buffalo's going back in the game. There's Simone Simmons, 6 foot senior. She was, her presence was definitely missed.
Yes.
After a slow start, first quarter, with the Bearcats led 14-4. Buffaloes outscored the Bearcats 10-8 in that second dish. And starting off third with a deep three-pointer there.
What a statement to make right after halftime.
22-17. Pass over the top. Providence looking at it.
Back out to
Garden City definitely going to give the Bearcats the three-pointers. Bearcats hit some of the first quarter. They kind of gone dry. Been trying to look inside, find inside there. Garden City went to man-to-man into Rusher. Too strong off the glass. On the floor.
Jump ball.
Gardner, jump ball with Simmons. Ball stays with the Bearcats. Again, Garden City kind of change up. I'm talking to the Garden City gentleman right next to me here. First game was last night. He told me that their team had a shutdown mode, and they just started practicing about a week and a half ago.
Oh, wow.
This team first game was last night against Great Bend. Had a victory. So congratulations to the ladies here.
Yes, absolutely.
Yep. Good job for the win last night. Get on the road, travel. I think they just want to play a game. That's the motto, but here it is. They just want to play games.
Yeah, we just want to play.
Absolutely. I'm sure they want to play too. These girls are competitors. They don't want to sit out. We all understand the roles and the reasons why, the COVID, the pandemic we have going on, but everybody still wants to play.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah.
Buffalo's trying to cut into this five-point lead. Oh, nice swat. Sydney Providence put it right back
there
down.
There we go.
Yeah.
To Rusher. Rusher's driving it up.
Caught by Gallegos.
Yep, Sydney trying to get soft off the glass. No good there.
I think that was Rusher,
sorry,
actually.
Aspen. That was Aspen. Kicking out.
Tatum Rusher caught the ball. He's just going to drive.
Tatum. Yeah, she got that one in. Tatum Rusher with a quick basket here. And we're having a timeout here on the court. Quick timeout here with Bob Buffaloes. Coach saw something he didn't like there. 24-17, 2 minutes in the second half. 6 minutes remaining. We're going to take a break here. Bearcat Sports Network brought to you at First National Bank of Omaha. And we're back here. Third quarter action. Bearcats lead Buffaloes 24-17. I keep saying Buffaloes. I keep thinking Gibbon. You know, just right down the road to Gibbon Buffaloes.
Yep. So,
no, wrong every state, now and then,
I know, wrong
state.
I know. And kind of wrong school size.
Yes. Oops.
Okay. Garden City plays 6A. The largest classification in Kansas is 6A.
Wow.
Which, I mean, honestly, it's pretty close to ours because, you know, in essence, we're – Class A. Nice strong by Novacek. But actually, Nebraska has six classes, too, because we have C1, C2, and D1, D2. So, in essence, Nebraska has six classes. So, you know, Garden City is a 6A school, would be in Nebraska standards, at Class A. Very, very similar. And actually, here's an interesting point. You want to tell here? If you go to Garden City High School and you come to Kearney High School, they're very close to similar situations here. If people didn't know this, about 7 years ago, when at Kearney High we had passed our bond issue to build a brand new high school, Garden City, oh, nice pass here, inbound. Yep, kind of travel there by 30. Garden City was one of the schools that our team traveled to.
Really?
Yes, yes. So actually, if you go down to Garden City, you walk on their high school, and you walk on Kearney High School, you're like, wow, there's a lot of similarities. True, various. Our schools are very much patterned after each other. I'm that, no kidding. How do I know this? Because I saw Garden City High School. skip pass over there.
Novacek. Pitches it over to Tatum. Up for a three.
Two. Inside line. Yeah, actually, Guard City had set up like the SLCs that we used to have. Small learning communities. Guard City had their school set up kind of like pods, small learning communities area there.
Oh, my gosh, I remember those.
Their commons area is very similar. Their cafeteria is very similar. Their gym, you look here, their gym, very similar. Had this walkway up top. I'm kidding you. I will show you ladies' pictures. You give me this dumbfounded look like I have no idea what I'm talking about.
Well,
I get that a lot from you girls.
This is
truthful. I will show you pictures of Guard City High School. Very similar
you.
In layout to Kearney High.
I will believe it when I see it.
Offensive foul. I didn't like that one. She kind of leaned in and shoved in there. That's Simone Simmons' third. That was a screen. They're saying Simmons kind of put her head, arm down, and kind of shoved into it. Simmons didn't like that call at all. That's Simmons' third. Coach is going to leave her in, though. They're going to need Simmons inside there. Bearcats up 28-17.
Mm-hmm.
Cut to five. Bearcats on a 6-0 run right now. It was 22-17. Bearcats up 6-0. Spreads the lead back up to 11. Curling around. Rusher. Nope. No good. Calzanetti bringing the ball up. Stop three-pointer on the way. Nothing but net. Pretty shot there by Eileen Bessarel. Bearcats lead by 8. Nice follow through, nice form, nice everything. She got what she deserved, which is a 3-point basket. Rusher with the inside move, driving in. I think it's going to be on Simmons again. Yep. Got Simmons moving.
She's in foul trouble right now, guys.
Yeah, absolutely. That's her fourth foul. Got Simmons moving on the glass and taking it right at her. You know, that's smart play. Rusher, bounce around, no good.
So close.
Simmons going to take a seat on the bench there next to the coach. In for them, number 23, Melody Flores.
I will be surprised if she comes back out.
Now, we won't see her again until the fourth quarter.
At least.
Kaylee Hatcher in for Bearcats. Free throw good. That's Aspen's seventh point of the game.
The Lagos with the ball right now for the Buffaloes.
I do believe the Rusher girls are battling out for both of them have 7. So, yeah, there's going to be no trash talking at home, huh?
Classic sibling rivalry.
Yeah, you think? Oh, pass Hatcher, a little too far. Maddie Provitz started looking inside for Aspen. Oh yeah, whoever leads the score, yeah, there will be trash talking at home.
There will be
talking at home. They're competitive young ladies. That's what you want.
Provitz,
you don't expect anything different.
Sisters and Rusher sisters. Yep. I guarantee you that's the really.
Kaylee Hatcher, going to slide, swiping across number 11 Bessarel. I think that is Bessarel's second foul. No, her third. Bessarel's second foul. So Buffalo's definitely in foul trouble right now. You have Simmons with four, and Bessarel with 3. Hatcher off on the right, no good. In for the Garden City, McKenna Jagels. Bessarel will take a seat probably for the end of this quarter here.
Mm-hmm.
She'll be back and start a 4.
See, the way I look at it, you're not playing hard unless you're getting a foul. I'm just saying.
Well, you don't want a foul.
You don't want fouls.
Well,
but
I don't know about that.
But, I mean, I don't know how to put it.
Now, rest letting the hand check and go. But, oh, nice spin move there.
And
nice
in.
Spin to it. Roll there. 33, Kayana Turner. That's Kayana Turner's 6th point of the game. She has 1 foul. 3-pointer from Garner on the way. Off back iron. Rebound. Ladies laughing. Novacek jumped up, came down with the rebound. But the problem was Aspen Rusher's head was in the way.
Yeah.
When she came down, she boinked it off Aspen's head. And the ball went out of bounds. They all looked at each other and both kind of smiled again.
Hey, it's always good to have fun.
Hey.
As long as nobody gets hurt.
You know, you want to be competitive, but it's still a game. Nice backdoor cut there.
Those
Hatcher.
Are the memories that will last a lifetime. And those two are seniors, so yep. It's good to make those memories now.
Okay, on a Turner with a basket. Back to 5. 6-point run for the Buffaloes. Been a game of runs so far.
And
Buffaloes,
right,
Buffaloes had a 7-point run, get within 5. Bearcats had a 6-point run, get to 11. Kaylee Hatcher for 3, no good. Ripped away. And now Buffaloes on a 6-point run to get back to 5 with the ball. Chance to get down to one possession game. Going coast to coast. Oh, up, no good. Can't determine. She'll go to the charity stripe for 2, though. That'd be Novacek's first foul.
Tatum Rusher, number 33, Cindy Province. And they're coming in for Novacek and Aspen Rusher. Kiana Turner got her last 3-throw in as Gardner brings the ball down on the Bearcat side. She's trying to set some up. Pass off to Province, to Hatcher.
7-0 Buffalo run, get within game within 4. Province, nice spin move, nothing there. Good defense by the Buffaloes there. A Bearcat turnover. Couple turnovers right here, and a couple missed shots. Bearcats. Buffalo's on a nice little 7-0 run right now. We get within 4. Buffalo's trying to make this one possession game going into the final frame. Nice drive, off the glass. Nice job. Seeing lane there by Gallegos. Drive and attack. Buffalo's trying to find their feet there now. 9-point run by the Buffaloes. Bearcats trying to find something going on. At one time, this game was 29-18 with a little over 3.5 minutes to go there. In the last 3 minutes, Buffalo's on a 9-0 run. Bearcats hold for the last shot. Kind of felt reminiscent of last night, huh? Bearcats held an 11-point lead with 4 minutes remaining in the game last night.
Oh, yeah.
And came down to a final shot there. Bearcats held, but struggled in that one. So, final 10 seconds. Cut inside. Good job. 4-3. We're getting a shot off. 3-pointer. And it no good. Bounce off the irons a couple times. And we go to the final. We go to the fourth. Bearcats lead 29-27. We got ourselves a ball game, ladies and gentlemen. We'll be back here after a short break. Bearcats Sports Network, brought to you by First National Bank of Omaha. And we're back. Bearcat fans here. We got ourselves a good one here. Garden City's clawed themselves all the way back, 33-31.
But it's still anyone's game, Goff. As I always say, it is anyone's game until that final bell rings. But so far, it's still been a very, very good game.
All right, and we're back here, 5:41 remaining. Bearcat basketball, first time they're trailing. See how that adversity is going to strike the Bearcats. Shots just are not falling. Again, at one time, Bearcats led 29-18. Ever since then, halfway through the third quarter, it's been all Garden City. Mm-hmm. Bearcats have other chances, just can't make the buckets drop. Man-to-man defense. Garner right through the fingertips, lucky to get back here. Or Province. Rusher.
Back to Gardner.
It said when they switched from the zone to man, the Bearcats has picked up, which is odd. Three-pointer on the way. That's nothing but net. Sydney Province. That's her eighth point of the game. Bearcats up ahead, now lead by one. Drive. Yep. Lily wasn't quite set there. Nice drive. Seeing a lot of drive, backdoor cuts and cuts action here. Buffalo's run that play, the same play over and over, but you know what? It's working for them right now. And they're scoring off it. So far, Simmons is still on the bench. Bearcats lead by one. Gallegos, who's come on strong in the second half. Got to bet. Can bring it back out, reset it. They're going to reset it. Look for a screen on the left side. Bearcat switch, defense. They're looking for a screen left side to a roll play for Gallegos rolling there. They've run that play about three times and they scored over every single time. Bearcats are set for them there. 33 is Keanu Turner is going to set the screen. Nice drive of Keanu Turner. Kick out for three. Blocked by Aspen Rusher. Right in the hands of Turner. Nice roll. Ball right back to Calzanetti. Pump fake. Got Bearcat online. I think it's Lily Novacek. Nope, Sydney Province. That's Sydney's third. Calzanetti is going to the free throw line for two. First one up, no good. 4:04 remaining. We're halfway through the final frame. Second free throw up, and it's good. We're all tied up here. We played 28 minutes and proved nothing. 34-34, ladies and gentlemen. We have a final four. It's going to be a good one. Glad you guys are tuning in here. Bearcat Sports Network brought to you by First National Bank of Omaha. Skip pass outside to Novacek. Over to Garner for three. It's good. Nice job, Kirsten.
And Coach Fletcher just tore his mask off, guys. That was awesome.
Oh. You got to move it up, walk. Nice job trying to hold the ball, but she was on her left foot there and hold the ball. It's kind of moved to the right, kind of took a little hop step there. Can't do that one. Refs don't like that one. They call a whistle when that happens. That's a traveling call.
Yes, and that is
good time for the Bearcat. On the roll there, Aspen Rusher, kick back out. Sydney Province for three. Nope, in and out. Gallego, strong rebound. Three of Maya Gallegos kind of threw the brakes on right in front of Aspen. Nice roll play there. Oh, no good. Gets her own rebound. Nope. Foul on the floor by Novacek. Novacek had it in her hands. Turner kind of went all the way around her, kind of popped it out of Novacek's hands. Novacek, you know, that's one of those. You get that rebound, bring it down strong, and Lily did not do that. And allow Turner to come around and kind of pop it. Stay with the Buffalo. It's kind of almost a turnover there for the Bearcats. And to get that rebound, you got to bring it down strong. 3 minutes remaining. Bearcat lead by three. Go! screen and rolls. That screen game not working right now. Bearcats are doing a good job of switching off on defense. Nice drive by Gallegos. Off, no good.
Caught by Sydney Provins.
That's a sad. You know, Sydney brought it down stronger in there. Nothing Gallegos could have done. Novacek, yep, kind of dribbled. Took a step too quick there. She saw a lane there. Lily saw an opening gap there. Try to go just a little bit too early. Got to put the ball on the ground. 2:20 remaining. Bearcats picking up full court defense here. Put a little pressure on the ball handlers. Oh, that's a reach here by Maddie. Mm-hmm. That I do will send Gallegos to the free throw line, though. That's her second foul. Buffalo is in the 1-1. Guards, and he has four fouls, so a couple more fouls before the Bearcats start shooting in the bonus. First shot, no good. Nice rebound by Aspen Rusher. Go back and look at some tape there, ladies and gentlemen. Young basketball players, see what Aspen did right there. Jumped in front, blocked out the shooter because Gallegos knew exactly what was going to happen there. But Aspen Rusher blocked her out. That's fundamental basketball right there by Aspen Rusher. Bearcat's going to pass it around. Going to try to kill some clock. Bearcats are trying to drive. Move, and press. They're going to try to bring him out there. Yep. The whole odd offense is trying to bring him out. You bring it out, you get those cut, and those lanes are going to open up there. And that's what the Bearcats are looking for an easy basket. Trap. Province got away from it. Garner, kick it outside. Novacek. Foul draped on the top there. 23 on the foul. That's Melody Flores. That's only the fifth foul in Garden City. Timeout on the floor. All right. A little confusion on the court there. Referees looking at both teams. I think both coaches literally yelled timeout the same time. That's kind of what we looked at.
So how do you call that?
Well, they both yelled timeout. They pointed to the Kearney side, though they awarded the timeout to Kearney. And the Kearney coach like, no, give the timeout to them.
Does it really matter?
That's what I'm like. We're 1:30 remaining, and both teams, I believe, have four timeouts. So I think there's a lot of timeouts. You know, if you have one left, I can see it. But there's, I think both teams have four timeouts. We'll check when the scoreboard comes back up there. But Bearcats have two timeouts left. Garden City has four. So that's why they want to do it even out. That'd be fair. Come on. No. Guard C coach. No. Give it to them. All right.
We drove 4.5 hours. It's theirs.
92 clicks on the clock remaining. Bearcats lead by 3 with the ball. This is a huge possession. Bearcats get it here. Make it a 2-point possession. Nice roll pass into Province. No good. Tipped out backside. Ball's on the ground. Kind of a scramble or a scrum. I don't know who that ball's off. I think it's off Gardner. Yep. Ball's off Gardner. No one can really get a handle on it there. And the arrow actually is pointing to Kearney. That's why Kearney wanted to jump ball. They would retain possession. There's a timeout. All right. Timeout on the floor. The 1:24 minute. We're going to take it with them here. Bearcat Sports Network brought to you by First National Bank. Bearcats lead 37-34.
Life is already full of things to worry about. Like mornings. With First National free checking, we've eliminated the worry. Life is already full of things to worry
about. Yeah, welcome back here, Bearcats. Final 1:24 remaining in this ball game here. Kearney leads 37-34 over the visiting Garden City Buffaloes from Kansas. 4 hours drive for the ladies here. Put up a good show. Bearcats led by 11 midway through third quarter and an 11-0 run tied the game. And then Ben's been back and forth ever since. And last Kirsten Garner three-pointer has put the Bearcats up by three. Garden City ball, here we go. Nice pass out of 23. I think partially blocked. I think Sydney got a hand on that one.
Was it Novacek or Sydney?
I think Sydney got a hand on that one. Trap. Bearcats got to get the ball over.
Timeout.
Okay.
Timeout on the floor.
Yep, timeout on the floor, Coach Fletcher. What are you doing? You know, honestly, true, we're going to stick it right here with them here. You know, ball is good pressure defense by Garden City, and he was counting 10. You know, that's what a good coach will do. He's counting 10 because he didn't want a backcourt violation, and he's 10, 9, and soon gets about 2 seconds left. He called his timeout because he knew he has one remaining now because he did not want backcourt violation. Kearney basketball. Garden City has a couple fouls to give. I do believe Garden City's at 5 team fouls, maybe six. Our scoreboard's not up right now. It's either 5 or 16 fouls. So either one or two is going to put in the bonus. Kearney will probably dribble out a little bit. Garden City will go for the steal. My guess is about the 45-second mark, then they'll start hack.
Yeah.
It'll be start hitting a little bit here. I'm going to send Kearney to the free throw line. Or they might actually commit a real quick foul. You'll see the fouls maybe go really fast and then try to go for the steal and play there. But if not, they're going to try to send Kearney. My guess is Kearney's going to try to keep the ball in Kirsten Garner's hands. Pretty good free throw shooter. All right. Teams are coming back on the court here. See what Coach Fletcher draws up. Again, Kearney with one timeout remaining. Garden City 3. Kearney ball. 5 team fouls. Garcia has 5 team fouls, 2 more for the bonus. Again, noticeably absent this entire second half has been Simone Simmons. But, you know, Garden City's made a run better, so maybe the smaller lineup has gone well for them. Aspen Rusher.
That is a foul. Yep. So they do
that
have
That was
six.
A good job. Yep, that was a good job by Rusher seeing that because she's on the sideline there. The trap was coming, and she got there quickly. And fouls on play by number 5, Julie Calzanetti. Yep, they're looking for the trap. Right there. Bearcats moving the ball around. There's the second foul there. Sydney Providence going to free throw line. Going to shoot one on ones. 49.4. Bearcats take about 15 seconds off the clock there. Big, big free throw here for Sydney Providence, senior. Strong. Rebound comes down to 11, Eileen Becerrell. Guard to the ball. They got a three-pointer to tie. Switch defense, going to drive around. No good. Novacek, strong rebound in the hands of Garner. They're going to trap here. Oh.
Foul.
Yep. I don't think that. Yeah, Garden City coach was. He was like, you can see him as soon as they fouled. He's like, no. Because he had a backcourt trap all set up right there. That Garner in that corner. Two people around. Great trap. It'd be one of those, you go back to the film, he's going to tell his girls, hey, have your hands up, we had her. We had her there in 10-court violation. But my guess is Kearney had one timeout remaining. Fletcher is going to call timeout. Garner on the free throw line. Shot no good. Bearcats missed two front ends, one-on-ones. See, that doesn't cost them, though, in the game here. Buffaloes need a three. All the way, that's tipped. I heard it from up here. Foul on the play. Three-pointer was on the way. It was partly tipped. We kind of heard it. Then it kind of a dumb ball around. Bearcats had it. She was falling out of bounds. Threw it back in off her teammate. It hit her teammate.
On number 23.
It hit her teammate in the head. But the ball stayed in. So
the ball works in mysterious ways.
But, yeah, heroes. But Sydney Providence came down with it. Foul on play here. 8 seconds remaining. This is 1-1 again. Huge one right here with 8 seconds remaining. huge free throw. And it's in good. 4-point play. Bearcats pretty much now play they'll play full court pressure defense here. Make Buffaloes kill some time going there. Even the Buffaloes take it. Hit a three-pointer. Bearcats still lead. Providence trying to move it to five. Second shot, no good. And no foul. Pressure defense there. Time's going away. They're just going to let her go in. Take that.
And that's game.
And that's game. Garden City looking for something. Nope. And that's ball game there. Nice drive there by Amaya Gallegos. She's trying to drive in there, but the rebound here kind of killed the timeout. Oh, hold on. Nope. The referee said we were putting .4. I kind of almost agree with that one here. Okay, we're going to stick with here. We're going to stay right here. Gallegos took it in now, and she drove all the way length of court because it's a two-possession game. So she dropped it in there. I thought, like, okay, timeout. I was like, okay, yeah, go. But, there was a little bit of time left here. They put 0.4 seconds on the clock. Be interesting. Now, the Bearcats, and honestly, as soon as the ball's touched, the clock will start. So there's a lot of different ways coaches do it. I've seen a coach do one time a volleyball play. Lily kind of doing a thing, and all of a sudden just kind of throw it up. And Lily will just, like, volleyball it to half court. Just Lily, like, hit it. Because as soon as the ball's touched,
The
clock's going to start. And it won't even come down. Or I've seen a lot of times here, I've seen somebody throw it three quarters of the length. They throw it three quarters of the length. And just, okay, somebody just jumps it. By the time they catch it, by the time you jump up and catch it, come down, then you got to throw it three quarters of the length and make the shot to win. But .4, all they got to do is get the ball inbounds. And I say about the Bearcats is Kirsten Garn's going to run it. She can run the baseline. She has a full baseline to run. That's a huge advantage. Yep, there it is, full court length. Sees. Yep. That's exactly how it was devised up there. Good perfection with Coach Fletcher. Good game here. And that's a final here at Kearney High School. And that's a final there, Kearney High School. Bearcats win 38-36. Leading scorer for the Bearcats with 9, Sydney Providence for the Buffaloes, number 13. That's Amaya Gallegos. We're gonna keep the stream going, but we're gonna kick our audio off, and we'll be back.
We'll be back
for the boys game here at Kearney High School. Glad you're tuning in, Bearcats Sports Network, brought to you by First National Bank of Omaha.